Hello, today we will show how to configure truck mode, as well as associated parameters, in iRev. For demonstration purposes, we already have a scale set up and are connected to the 920i indicator. If you need more information on setting up a scale, please watch our other video titled Setting Up and Configuring Scales in iRev. We will start by going to the left side of the screen and selecting System Parameters. Once that pane is open, we will then click the Features icon. Here we have access to 5 submenus, but we will only be using 3 of them. First, we will turn on our truck mode. Truck mode allows us to weigh vehicles, and if we so choose, we can save the container weights so that we can simply perform a weigh out at a later time, and it will recall the tare weight of that vehicle. To determine the best truck mode for your purposes, please consult the 920i manual and refer to the section titled Truck Mode. I will choose Mode 3, which allows for save tares, value swapping, and keyed tares. Now that I have enabled truck mode, I need to ensure that I can use it. For this, we will proceed to the Soft Keys tab. We will add several soft keys so the customer can have the associated soft keys for truck mode, as well as an additional soft key for manipulating the time and date without the need to use iRev. To do this, we will go to the left side, titled Available Soft Keys, and we will select Weigh In. Once Weigh In is highlighted, we will add it to our selected soft keys by clicking the right arrow. The Selected Soft Keys column shows all the soft keys that will be displayed on the 920i. I will also add 3 more soft keys. Both Weigh Out and Truck Regs also have to do with the truck mode operations, and we will add the Time and Date soft key for the customer. If you have more than 5 soft keys, the system will automatically detect it and change the 5th key to a More key, allowing you to have access to more than 5 keys on a system. Now, if your customer asks you, or your regulatory agency requires it of you, you can go to the Formatting tab and specify how you want your time and date to appear and print. We will now go to the Formatting tab. I will change the time format to 24-hour and change the date separator to a dash instead of a slash. To make sure our truck in and truck out tickets print properly, we will now want to set the print destinations for our formats. We know that our customer has their printer on port 3. So we will set the truck in and the truck out tickets to print to port 3. We will now proceed to the Print Formatting tab on the left side, and then select Print Format Information. Here we have access to all the print formats available to us in the 920i. For this demonstration, we will select Truck In Format. This allows us to perform several actions, like setting up the page size, printer type, and communication port. Selecting a printer type changes the page size and gives us access to different commands under the printer control code sequences that are available in the ticket editor. But for now, we will ignore that section. The only thing we will change is the communication port from none to serial port number 3. We have one ticket set properly, but we also need to change the truck out and the truck register ports if we want to be able to print those formats. So we will select Truck Out Format and set the communication port to serial port number 3. Now for the truck register, we know our customer wants to use his audit trail printer on port 4 instead of the ticket printer on port 3. So we will select Truck Register Format and set the communications port to serial port number 4. Now that all of our printer formats have been set up, we can download this information to the indicator. So we will go to Communications and select Download Configuration. After the download box pops up, we will check both the standard configuration as well as the print formats checkboxes and then hit Begin. This has been a demonstration of configuring truck mode and its associated parameters through iRev. Thank you for your time.